Hello, I'll be demonstrating the use of the SOTA Magnetic Pulser. Our Magnetic Pulser model MP5 is shown here. It's our latest model. The Magnetic Pulser is powered by an AC to DC wall adapter. The wall adapter is rated at 12 volt DC output, 1.5 amps, and the power plug is center positive for polarity. It's really important that you get a wall adapter, if you're not using ours, that has the exact same specifications. If you use a wall adapter that's underrated or underpowered, the Magnetic Pulser may not work or take a long time to charge up. What's nice about our wall adapter are the blades themselves can be changed or interchanged for your different country. Each country has different blades for plugging into the wall. It's real simple. Just click it out. We can replace it with your blade and put your blades, click it into place. Now, powering the unit is very simple. We take our 2.1 millimeter center positive power plug, and on the back of the unit, not surprising, there is a power inlet, and you just simply plug it in. Push it in firmly. We've got our unit plugged in, and it's real easy to turn it on. There's a large on-off button. I hit it once. And take notice of the green lights and the red light. What you're noticing, the green lights are building up in sequence, and at the end of the sequence, a red light will flash. This is the actual measurement of the charge being built up inside the Magnetic Pulser unit, and the moment that the red light flashes, a pulse is being released into the coil. Now, as an option, we have an audible feature, and I'm going to turn it on. A little yellow light will come on, indicating that the audible option is now enabled, and as you just heard, it'll beep every time that the red light flashes, which beeps every time a pulse is released. And of course, this is for people who want to make sure that the pulse is working, and they may be just aware, you know, they may be visually impaired, and they just want to have some indication that the pulse is working. And you can turn it off real easy, just turn off the audible feature. Magnetic field itself emanates approximately 9 inches on both sides, this side of course being north and this side is the south side. The output is approximately 6,000 gauss. That's very, very high, very intense magnetic field. It's a pulse, it's a spike, which means there's no real frequency involved. It just comes out as a spike. And that's why the light flashes for that instant, showing a spike is being released. And it releases in about 2.5 thousandths of a second, very, very fast. So we have 6,000 gauss measured at the face of the coil, and all magnetic fields drop off, they call by the inverse square law. And all that means is if you double the distance out, rather than being half the intensity, it drops down to a quarter. So as you move away from the face of the coil, the magnetic field drops off very, very rapidly. That's why you want to have it as close as possible to target the area that you're dealing with. We can measure out approximately 9 inches, and it's about 100 gauss out here. Now, magnetic field is invisible. I can't feel it. Some people may be very sensitive to magnetic fields. They might be able to feel it. I certainly can't. And how do you know that it's actually releasing a magnetic pulse? Well, I'm just going to give you a little demonstration here. I'm going to put this down for a sec. What I've done is I've created a coil. I've just wound a coil of wire. There's about 300 turns in this coil. And I've connected up an LED light. There's no battery power. It's not powered by anything whatsoever. And what I'm going to do now is bring the coil close to the hand paddle, and I'm going to turn the audible option on, and each time that pulse is released, you should see that light flash. And so it's actually creating electricity across the gap. There it is again. Now I'm going to demonstrate it going right through my neck. Hopefully I do this properly. And there it is. And you should be able to see that light flash as a magnetic field penetrates right through my neck. I'll turn the audible option off. And I'll turn the unit, let me just turn off for a second here. The magnetic field itself, as I mentioned, comes out in like a conical shape, but the diameter is the diameter of the coil. So when you're using it, the north side, you can target an area, let's say 3 inches, and then you can move it around as you desire. You can either stay on one area or move it around. Very important that if you have a pacemaker, please do not bring the magnetic field in that area. We actually recommend that you do not use a pacemaker with our unit. We don't want to have any interaction because we don't know how it's going to interact with the pacemaker. As well as implants. Implants are made with usually stainless steel or titanium. Although they may not be attracted by the magnetic field, there could be some interaction either through heating or electrical current, and you may actually, it may be quite uncomfortable. So you can either test it on an implant or simply don't use it if you do have an implant. Another demonstration for the magnetic field, and I'll turn the unit on for a second here, is to, in your own home, you might want to find something that has a piece of metal in it, something that is magnetic. And I have a pair of pliers here. And what I'm going to do is bring the pair of pliers close to the magnetic field in the coil, and we should see some action. Oh my, okay, there it is. And as you can see, there was quite a strong attraction to the, there it is again. I've got to sort of hold it steady here because it is a very powerful field. There it is again. So in order for you to test your magnetic field in your house, you could put this against maybe the side of a fridge or an oven door, that type of thing, because the large metal, you can feel the magnetic field. And then you'll know at least it's going to be releasing properly. Now the unit will run for approximately exactly 255 pulses. However, the time to build up one charge may vary between unit to unit, just small tolerance differences. It takes approximately 5 seconds to do one pulse. And so you multiply 5 seconds by 255 pulses, and you may get a session of between 20 to 30 minutes. So that's completely normal. Also, the coil itself, because there's so much magnetic energy being released, the coil can get very hot. Now, it's completely normal. We have designed this to handle it running virtually all day long, 24 hours a day. So don't worry, you can't hurt the unit. However, if the coil does get very hot and uncomfortable to the touch, you can just put a small dish towel over the coil, or you just make sure that you don't put it directly against the skin. You might just put it through your shirt or something like that. Again, we know that the magnetic field basically penetrates right through all materials except for metal. It'll be diverted. So for all intents and purposes, magnetic field will go through the clothing like it's not even there. One thing you want to be careful of is make sure you don't place this against credit cards because the credit card has a magnetic strip and you could destroy your credit card. You don't want to place it near homeopathic remedies, and you want to keep it away from your computer discs. You don't want to destroy your computer discs. It's a very powerful field. Now the unit will go for, like I say, 255 pulses, and at the end of that time, the unit will go into sleep mode. The light will just stay on, it'll beep, and it'll just stay on, and you can continue to start another session just by starting the unit again by touching the on-off button, or if you just ignore it, and 30 seconds later, the unit will turn itself off. And it's real simple, it'll just turn off. I'd just like to also mention a little thing about the coil itself. Sometimes the coil may give out a little click or a little bit of noise every time the pulse is released, or it may not. We're trying to keep it as quiet as possible, but it's not unusual for some people to get a coil that has a little ticking sound. And all that means is that the coil inside is contracting so rapidly from the magnetic pulse that there's some movement inside the plastic. It's completely normal. So if there's, don't think that if your unit isn't making a sound that it's not working, And don't worry that if it is making a sound, there's something wrong either. It's, again, it's completely normal. And so that's the very simple operation of the magnetic pulser, MP5, and I wish you happy pulsing.